Tuesday, January 27th at 3:20 p.m. Oh, yeah. Jesus. Getting down the steps, up and down the stairs. It's a little difficult in the wintertime when it's cold out here. It's not really cold. It's probably in the 40s, mid to upper 40s. And I'm in a pair of shorts because I sit in the house off my feet as much as possible. I'm going to show you the plastic we got out here, but the wind out here, my gosh, I'll tell you. But it's, you know what? In the end, this is going to be one of the best gardens. It's 55 feet at least, 55 at least across from west to east. And it's about 44 feet. See, I didn't even cover over here. It's about almost about 3 feet from the edge of that plastic to the edge here where I had tilled. But see, this is, I just did this last one. From about here, I can't see with this crack on this lens. From here to the here, that I was going to put the plastic all the way here and put this on top of it. But see, now when I fold this in, I fold all the ends. Well, actually, I have to fold the whole thing up and till this whole garden and put some lime out here and till the lime into the soil and put the plastic back out. Well, actually, we're going to till it with lime, put lime in the soil. We're going to take a bed frame. See, the thing is, we don't have no weight per se. But my wife and I are going to take bed frame after I get this tilled up really good. And we're going to just walk. It's going to take forever. Walk back and forth across this thing to level it out as best as possible. Then I'm going to till the edges at least about a foot in here. I'm going to fold the plastic in all the way around in, till it. Fold it out and put the dirt on top of that. You know what I'm saying? Where all this is, it'll be shoveled on top of the plastic all the way around. Except for that middle part. That's the only part we're going to have a challenge with that. I don't know how we're going to do that. See, I got everything. Like I said, I got a little bit of everything. I got my tiller out here on it. I got some manure. I got an old bucket of old paint. It's no good. And I got some cement slabs out here, like that one over there, if I can see it right there. And that, and I put a roll rake through the plastic into the ground, get an old junky ass, a junk hot water heater that Andy, who got the plastic for me, gave me that to hold the plastic down before I even got it spread out earlier. And then I cut it, my wife and I put it down here about a week ago. And like I say, when this is all said and done, it'll look a lot better. I mean, it looks pretty bad, but to a lot of people that don't know, this is really going to be great. This is going to heat up the ground so much more. Let's see, it's the 27th, I said, of January. By the second week of February, I will have stuff planted in the house. By the end of February even, perhaps, depending on how the frost is, you know, we're going to start putting our stuff out here. We'll have so much out here, too. I mean, without the grass, you know, we about 24 to 36 inches in between each row. And just, you know, take a planter, you know, bulb where you just dig it out of a hole like that. What I do is make little X's with, you know, cut an X in the plastic, and take the corners and fold it up underneath the plastic, and then pick it up, take a plug out right there and put the plant in it. We can get over 150 plants out here, which is going to be way more than what we need, and it probably be next to impossible, but I don't care. I'm going to do as many as I can out here. Peppers, tomatoes, and okra will be in the first rows closest to the east over here. Eggplant might go in the back row or near the back. I mean, there's going to be so much out here. Like I said, watermelon, we have to design it where the watermelon and zucchini and such, when they have vines like squash and all that, they go on vines. But see, I can't put a fence down on top of the plastic like this. I'm going to have to let it just run on the plastic, which, you know, I was told that could do it that way. But I have some cages I'm still going to take out here for like peas and tomatoes. Well, I'd rather them be inside the cages. I've got about 15 or 20 cages that I can puncture into the plastic and put around the tomato plants and the, tomato and the peas. And like I say, okra will grow up. Man, this is going to be this should be a great garden in 2015. Something happens with what we call the mafia. I mean, government. That's what you call it, the government. I call it the mafia because that's what they act like. So unless they come up with some kind of BS, this would be where we're going to have the garden out here. It'll be 56 feet by about 44 feet. 44 feet east to west, I mean north to south, and east to west would be 56 feet. So just want to get this out here and get it on so you can see what we got planned for out here. It looks like crap. It really does to me anyway. With all the stuff I got, designed and stuff all over the plastic. Man, even with this stuff, I had the wind blow this stuff up a couple times. You can see it right there how it's all bunched up. You know, I mean, I'm out there and I almost broke my neck a couple times. I'm walking with a cane out there on this plastic and I slipped and I almost broke my leg. I mean, it's just ridiculous, but it'll get done here in another couple weeks. My wife and I'll be out here, we'll get a push broom, get most of this contaminated rainwater off the plastic into the contaminated grass. And with a little bit of contaminated rain will come down throughout the year, but we're going to water it once every, I'd say about every 18 days. Every 18 days we'll water it with well water, which is contaminated water also, but not as bad as the stuff up in the sky. We put another strip of plastic over there by where the peppers were last year. Oh, I can't see with the sun in my face. There it is right there. That's where the plastic, where the peppers were last year. So I don't know how we're going to do that. I have no idea what I'm going to do with that. I mean, I got to do something to till it up. I'll come out a little bit further too, with the shed, about where that blue tote is. And just, again, do the same thing. Use the soil to hold down the plastic on the ends. But the wind out here has been, it's ripped up the plastic around my air conditioners. I mean, the wind out here, 26 mile an hour gust, 30 mile an hour gust, and it tears up everything. That's why I gotta get this done when it calms down, and hopefully it'll warm up into the 60s. You know, by the second week of February, we might have a few days in the 60s, we'll get out here and do that. And I don't know if the wind is blocking a lot of this or not, so. But anyway, that's the condition of what the garden looks like. The 2015 garden is going to be a big garden, 56 by 44 feet at least. So